Hello, my dear ones. It's been a couple of weeks now since I've been able to do a video for you. I apologize for that, but we had our iridology class, and I thought that was fun. I said I would never do an iridology class, and look, I turned around and did one. But we need to bring it up to date. We need to bring iridology up to date, and of course, we've learned so much about what iridology can also show us that others are not aware of, that you need to look at our level of iridology, because it's understanding that you're looking at two processes of acute, subacute, chronic, and degenerative, one of the lymph system and then one of the tissue itself. So fun stuff, and I always like to have our seminars and classes. I think we periscoped some of it. Some of you got to see that. That was great stuff. That was a lot of fun. Somebody sent in this from, I'll say this is from Texas. Maybe they don't want to give any names or anything. I don't know, but this is strange stuff. This came out during a detox. And this is, look at this. It looks like plastic. Hard as a rock. And looks like coal. That's what it looks like, coal. So you see with these things you're seeing coming out of yourselves, the acidic process, which creates a catabolic, or not really catabolic, a cationic process of coagulation and agglomeration, meaning things start sticking, dehydrating, of course, and getting hard as a rock. And that's just what you see. You see it with too much radiation to the body. You see it at all levels of acidosis, how it hardens the body. You see it when you're stiff and tight in the neck. That's your lymph system. That's all acids you're not removing out of the body. And of course, if you don't remove these acids from the cells' metabolism in a timely manner, they'll blow back on the cells and then damage them. That's what we call cancer. Up to that point, it's just inflammation, meaning that, ouch, hurt. It's extracellular. It's on the outside of the cells, meaning it's all interstitial. So really, most people suffer on cell poop, if you really looked at it. You know, most of our problems lie in our sewer systems, not in our kitchens. We can fix our kitchens pretty easy. It's the sewer system that's the problem, because it's massive size. Remember, around cells are spaces. So you have 100 trillion cells with spaces around every one of them. Sometimes cells in the blood, the red blood cells, will start following each other like choo-choo trains, or clustering like that, or clustering in groups. Of course, that again shows the slight move of the pH of the blood, and also enzymatic less foods. You know, when you start, enzymes are a major part of life. They are the little chemical intermediaries, we might say, because there's an enzyme needed in every chemical process on the planet. So it's just massive to think of the chemistry and the chemistry needed to make all this happen. But you can't think about that and then understand health as well. You have to understand health first and then take a look at the subatomic and some of these other levels that are nano levels and things like that, because too lost do we go. So I want to get into some Q&As. I'm so far behind, I know it. But you all are so beautiful, and I know you're working your programs. Again, I hate when if one of you are suffering real bad, you call the clinic or the club here. You get a hold of someone to help you. Don't wait for me to answer these, because with our schedules now, and we're trying to set time aside here. So let me see here. First, may I take the time to say thank you for your wealth of knowledge you share with the world. Oh, thanks, man. I personally owe you for kidney regeneration from stage 3 to healthy filtering kidneys. Yeah, well, this is a good testimony right here. There's a man at stage 3 kidney failure. Now his kidneys are filtering and back to normal. We just had a case, a lady that wanted us to do a protocol on her. She's in dialysis, but she's still peeing quite well. She has some flakes, and it's like, why do they have her on dialysis? Numbers, creatinine levels are up there pretty high, but they told her kidneys have failed, but she's still peeing and she has minor filtration. It'd be nothing to turn this all around for and save those kidneys. You know, even stage fives, you know, you can pull these around. Kidney tissue loves to regenerate. There's not too much tissue that doesn't like to regenerate except the nervous system, and that, of course, it loves to regenerate if your frequency is high enough, and that's why the fruits and the berries and the melons for nerve regeneration. Essential. Vegetable power is not adequate for human nerve regeneration at all. So this is good. I'm so happy you saved your kidneys. Everyone, this guy or gal, who is this? Oh, this is Ryan. Dear Ryan, man, you saved your kidneys. Proud of you, man. Proud of you. You guys can save all your tissues in your body, fix your bodies up, and learn more about how to take care of yourself. You don't need to spend all the money to go to physicians and stuff. They don't know how to do any of those things. But, you know, there are stabilization effects of ERs when you need them, but outside of that, congratulations. And being well on their way to a clean, healthy body. Congratulations, Ryan. I contact you regarding my uncle whose health has started to deteriorate the last few years. He's 56. Yeah, you know, you're seeing a lot of 56 going on 70s. That's what you're seeing out there. I'm amazed at the 56-year-olds that look in their upper 60s or 70s. There's a lot of old-looking 50-year-olds, and it's like, man, wow. That shows you how acidic and how fast the humans are deteriorating. And just look at what you're eating. You have to look at your lifestyle to not lie to people and to tell them that what they eat has nothing to do with their health. That's dark agey. And I don't think there's too many people that really believe that, although there are, I know. But it's amazing how many people actually bought into that. Even as a baby, I knew what I ate made a difference, except when it came to dairy products. Thought they were good for you. So this man's 56, a lifetime of acids. Yeah, mainly the sad American Western diet, I bet. He's an alcohol drinker, mainly Lager and beer. 2 years ago, he had what was the first suspected to be cellulitis in his right leg whilst on holiday in Thailand. After flying home, he was told he had DVT and was taking medication. 1 year later, he is back on holiday in Thailand, where he spends most of his time drinking beer and eating acid foods, and the ladies are gorgeous too. Thai women are some of the most beautiful. He was admitted to hospital after collapsing. Whoa. He had extreme low oxygen after a chest x-ray was told he'd previously had a minor heart attack and that he apparently didn't know about or they didn't discover. You know, there's all these what we call silent heart attacks out there. And a lot of times someone will get a real pain in the chest or something. They don't think much about it. Sometimes it's gas, you know, and then sometimes it's not, because you have real gas backing up here can make you feel like you're going down. But a lot of silent heart attacks out there where there's short little ischemic type changes there where, you know, some of the tissue is damaged. And the eyes can show a little of that, but an EKG can show that if you're a real avid EKG reader. I used to be an avid EKG reader. Man, I forgot a lot of it so many years and years ago that I had to take all my tests and do that. All right, he then undertook a CAT scan that found a large pulmonary embolism, I betcha, of the lung. Look at that. One which the doctor said he had never seen one so large. After multiple small nodes seen, pre-trachea, AP window, but mass-like lesion 4x2 centimeters at subcranial region is found with tissue diagnosis recommended. The doctor made a comment that they thought this would be found to be cancer. An embolism? Also, hiatal hernia showed. He has taken emergency medication to try to remove the embolism. He still has DVT in both legs. From watching your videos, I know his kidneys are... Yeah, you hit it right on the head, Ryan. Kidneys, kidneys, kidneys. You know, we only have so many tissues in the body. And when you start seeing swelling, cholesterol plaquing, calcifications or calcium problems, heart problems, circulatory problems, I mean, all those things, this is all acidosis. Matter of fact, there's not too many things or experiences or conditions that you can't name that doesn't have its cause in acidosis. There's just not too many. Probably 95% of what medical doctors think they call diseases, it's all acidosis and the effect acids have on your tissues. And that's, you know, it breaks them down. You know, no difference in Coca-Cola, piece of meat and Coca-Cola. Same pH as all your metabolitic acids. Uric acid, a little fungal meat acid, that might be a little hotter. But I doubt if uric acid's much hotter than 2.75, something in there. That's still pretty friggin' hot. I'll tell you the truth, when Coca-Cola's 2.9, I think, and Pepsi's 3, 3.1, Dr. Pepper, all in there, it's around the 3s. So when you go, ow, that hurts, that's 3 pH. Well, 3 pH is enough to destroy your cells. And then, of course, your stomach acid is another about 15 to 20 times hotter than that. And then, of course, chemotherapy falls about 20 to maybe 50 times hotter than that. So you're so hot when you're down to these levels that it destroys you. Your tissues anyway, your body anyway. Hiatal hernia, okay, so that you want to be looking at this parathyroid of your uncle. And of course, your uncle's an alcoholic and everything, or drinks a lot of alcohol and things. So extremely acidic, sucking the calcium out of him. Please, could you do a YouTube video and explain the seriousness of his case if he doesn't make changes to his lifestyle and begin detoxification? Well, Ryan, yeah, I mean, whoever, your uncle probably needs to really lift his head up. Some people can, some people can't. But Ryan's uncle, you definitely are in trouble. There's no question about that. A pulmonary embolism could have taken you out right there. But if you're having arrhythmias and things like that, if you've had a heart attack already, it means you're occluded. So I don't know what they've scanned and what they've done to show you, you know. See how occluded the coronaries are. But whenever you're going after occlusions or blockages anywhere in the body, what system are you going to go after? Now, this is affecting his blood system. Now, if you go after his circulation, you will fail. Because the problem isn't circulatory. The effect is circulatory. The cause is lymphatic. Going right back to what Ryan's saying, here's his kidneys. And that's exactly it. We're looking at causative factors as opposed to effects. And just remember that. Sometimes you're looking at an effect, and you have to ask yourself, what's the cause? Well, when you're asking about what the cause is, you have to pull all the way back to your chemistry ingestion and the chemistry of all this whole thing and take a look at it. Understand what the dominant chemistry is on the planet, which is base, and understand the blood a little bit and understand that. It's not difficult. It sounds it, but it really isn't difficult, to tell you the truth. And through these videos, I'm trying to help you to take a look at those things in that way. Always think causative. I mean, the end is near for him if he doesn't take care of himself, no question. This, I think this has been indicated to him that these things are going to creep up on him, either a stroke, a pulmonary embolism, or an MI, a big MI. So you're going to look at these things. If you're going to open your uncle up, he's in the perfect place to be. If he loves Thailand and the people of Thailand, then it's perfect. He's in the perfect place for what his problem is. He doesn't realize it, maybe. Thailand has some of the best fruit on the planet. So I remember a homeopath from Romania, when she went to Thailand, she said all my symptoms went away just eating the food, the fruit. So he's in the perfect place to just to bear down on fruit and berries and melons. He's in the perfect place to do that. And I would highly recommend that uncle of yours get himself down to a raw food diet and that before he offs himself. But if he offs himself, the problem with that is, thinking on the spiritual side, he'll be back. Now to some, that's no big deal. But to some of us, forget that. You know, if train stops here anymore, you want to stop on this rock and at this level of creation? Sucks. Pretty low, pretty, the pendulum of positive and negative is down here at the bottom, so it has the bigger swing. You get up in the middle worlds, you barely notice that there is duality. But boy, down in this level, phew-wee, it's so bad. But each side, remember this spiritually, the positive and the negative are simply the opposite side of the same coin. Remember, the coin is simply a shattered mirror of God, and all the little pieces of the mirror is God experiencing itself. If that alone exists, if everything is truly omnipotent, omnipresent, and omniscient, everything is truly the one, the all, then there is only the one. And nothing it creates can be anything but part of itself. Just like what you create is part of yourself. I cannot get out of that because it is a total entity. There is no you're there and that's there. You know, when you look at duality, you can say there's a chair there and I'm over here and there's separation between us. There's spaces in between the cells. That's not true in consciousness. Consciousness means that it's always there, ever pervading. There's nowhere that it isn't. So when you start learning that, you realize there's intelligence gripped in every single corner, space and black hole combined. Now, this is Miss Gill. And let me see. First and foremost, oh, thanks, honey. I appreciate that, sweetheart. Thank you, thank you, thank you. Working on this, working on the planet. We're all working on the planet together, and I think it's a lot of fun. It's fun to hear the remedies that you guys are going through. It's fun to hear when you overcome your problems. It's just exciting because it helps to show this planet how simple and how nature and the creator, however you wish to define that, everything's all set up. Man just has to start awakening to where he fits or she fits in the species and in the planet itself. You know, so it's just awakening up spiritually, meaning we need to wake up and realize we are indeed one being many and enjoying those differences. And, you know, lifting ourselves up a little bit. There's truly a warring planet this is. Oh, thanks, honey. I love you, too. Thank you. I immediately resonated with your teachings and know they are truth. I am using your herbs and eating mostly fruit and flushing out toxins with success. My question, why don't you contact Oprah to speak of? You know what? I'm not good at those things, to be honest with you. I would think, and I've always thought Oprah would be a good place to introduce this because she has a little bit of health-mindedness. She's had Oz on and other people, but this is a level way beyond those guys. And this is an incredible level, but it's in a level that bucks a lot of modalities, to be honest with you. There's a lot of things on this planet that shouldn't be, and one of them is dairy products. So dairymen across the world and dairymen's associations aren't going to be real happy, and they should already know this, though. Milk has been taught to be bad for you since day one. Why man feels he has to suck on a cow's teat, I have no idea. I have no idea. Wrong species, a big, huge animal, great for their babies. But where we ever came into that play only shows you that we migrated out of these tropical areas and into these northern climates, and we're willing to eat anything, including urine and stool and everything else, to try to be healthy. And it's like, what? So with that comes a little insanity of the human race. We have a beautiful, fruit trees are the way to go. And I don't know. So I would love to see something happen. We have some very interesting people that have come to us recently that are involved in some of these levels. And I'm working on their cases, and hopefully that when, one in particular, when she awakens to what she has in her hands, and she's a movie producer, so when she wakes up to what she has in her hands and Discovery Channel wakes up to what they can do, it's mind-boggling because no one on this planet is doing what you guys are doing and know what you guys know. You know that already. You guys can sit there, a lot of you, and whip off the parathyroid and calcium utilization, the pituitary. You guys can whip that out. There's not too many medical doctors in the world can whip that out. So I'm so proud of each and every one of you. Thank you. I'm humbled. Humbled that you're all taking this on because it's your survival. You know, you will be able to get yourselves well. You don't have to give the medical people the bank, you know, and still not get your remedy. But get yourself worse and worse and worse till you're climbing out of very bad hellholes. You know, some of these pharmaceuticals put you in hellholes and sad stuff. But you can work yourself out of them. And with the proper help and the proper understanding, you can move right along and kick butt. A lot of you are already doing that, proving that, and have proved that. I'm just real proud of each and every one of you. And if those of you who are struggling, it's worth it. It's worth it to hang in there. And there's some of you that you start off with good intentions, but when you're sitting there thinking about all fruit diet, all berries and melons, for let's say 6 months to a year, as you get down that road, things start stressing your emotions and your self-disciplines and minds. I get it. I came up on this planet too, so I understand how things work. But the happiness, the joy, the energy, the vitality, the awareness, what you get for the time you spend, there's no money on this planet worth it. You couldn't buy that. Your life will change 1,000%, as many of you have already seen, both spiritually, your connection to all of life, your happiness, your joy, your self-power, your ability to see and know things others can't, your vitality, your vigor, the ability to have endurance, that your ability not to have any fatigue in your world, maybe boredom because of a lack of activity, of things to do to keep you busy. It's worth every second you put into this in every way. So muster up that strength. Muster up that self-discipline. Remember, you're worth it. No, not your friends. No, you are worth it. Not your kids. You are worth it. Whoever you are that's listening to this, you are worth it. If you're 5 years old, you're worth it. If you're 10 years old, you're worth it. And if you're 102, you're worth it. This is from turquoise. Ooh, beautiful stuff. Oh, look at this, feather turquoise. Gmail, that's pretty cool. Hi, Dr. Morse, do you believe that past use of pharmaceuticals and vaccines blocks us on an etheric level as well as causes physical toxicity? Well, you know, that's a good question. Excellent question. You know, the interesting thing about that question is what we don't realize spiritually is that we're connected to all our etheric bodies. When we're so connected that the medical doctors think when we use our mind, we're using our brain, our physical brain. Let me tell you, this physical brain there isn't any fractional type of things we can compare that to the mind. The mind is the powerhouse of the whole of creation. The etheric world actually is just its high self. Some call it the subconscious, but that's the id, as Miss Carl Jung named it. The id, the ego. The ego simply means the individualized self, God individualizing itself. When that's accentuated, you think your side is better than the other side. And that's what's happened on this planet. Academics plays a huge role in that it sets you up for being smarter than your fellow man, which the joke is almost on the academics, because the more you work with your mind, the less awake you can be. You have to learn how to use your mind, but also be awake and not go mind chasing, or you'll spend years lost. And when you wake up, you go, just like waking up from a movie that was so good it lost you. You go, Oh, wow, I was sleeping. That's the human race, big time. So as you awaken, it's so cool. And it's so worth any time you put into this, because it's your world, your experience, not mine. I'm doing my thing. We're all doing our things to try to awaken more and more and more and get healthier and all that sort of thing. We each have that responsibility of ourselves. And you can do it or not do it. Doesn't matter. You can stay in the same body, the same for years and suffer all you want. You can fix it. You can leave it. But if you leave it without growing spiritually, from my account, you'll be back. And you'll be back until you do get it. And that's why it's so much better to get it. All right. And I do believe as you obstruct the human body with not only pharmaceuticals, but mucus, proteins, all this chemistry, as you obstruct the flow of energy, because that's what you're talking about, whether it's blood, nerve, or lymph. You're blocking the flow of energy. Well, the blood flow is vital, right? That's the kitchen to everybody. That's a nutritive supply, the energetic supply, the oxygen supply. All right, you have to have a sewer system, so the lymph system is the gigantic waste removal, and that's even for the blood. And then, of course, you have the nervous system that actually, it's the electrical department that actually turns everything on. So you've got to consider those three things, in particular in detoxification and people's health, the lymph and the nervous system. The blood, you change that by just changing your diet. And as you change your diet, the liver comes clean pretty easily, spleen, things like that. It's the miles of lymph, interstitial lymph, that's a big deal. And then the kidney weakness that sits on top of it, and it's adrenal buddy. So yeah, these are all big deals. But again, all your endocrine glands, and in Hinduism, I guess, in Buddhism, they refer to as chakras, but these are energy centers. There's no question they're energy centers. The production of hormones, steroids, neurotransmitters, and the like are essential for everything to happen. They're the overseers of the human body. And so they're definitely tied into the other bodies. So as they become weak, so can the other bodies. A good example is when you see someone emotionally weak, the physical body doesn't feel emotions. Something to think about. Your physical body has nothing to do with emotions. It is just physical cells. It's got a nervous system. It responds to touch, feel, things like that. With your other bodies, you're able to, one, categorize, the mind is able to categorize your experience of touch and feel and all that and relate to something else you touch and feel like, oh, that's hot, that burned me. You know, that's how the mind does it. It protects you, but it also can be make you into a slave to it. But it's how it is the academics. It categorizes, analyzes, all those things. But when you're feeling things, you're feeling with your astral, for lack of a better word, your emotional or astral, it's called, body. Now look up the Monroe Institute, John Monroe. He's mapped out the astral world extensively, and I've said this before, he has a institute that they work with getting you out of your body, and they say they have 97% success with beautiful music. Remember the old Pythagorean theories and stuff? We actually had a group called the Blue Hand Group, and they used to claim that Pythagoras could put his chelas, students, into ecstasy with just one strum of a musical instrument. Cool stuff, like Jonathan Rumi in The Whirling Dervishes. All the good stuff of man trying to find union again with its creator. Mm-hmm. That's because we feel isolated and separate, even though we're not. You can't be. There's no way you can hide, really. So, from that standpoint, my dear one, absolutely. Absolutely. You want to unobstruct, and when you do, you will find your experience. Now, once you drop the physical body, you're free of that a little bit. And you can then correct these other bodies a little better. Does using herbs and raw fruit diet detox these etheric and energetic blocks as well as detox us physically and emotionally? Absolutely. And I want you to think about this. Now, we teach this in these classes, so I don't want to give too much away in the classes because you come to hear it and it's a lot of good information, but let's talk about that. Every fruit, every berry, every melon, every vegetable, actually everything, also herbs, everything, also has a mental body, an emotional body, and a physical body. These are all essential to get here. You can't get to this world without these bodies in line. Now, you can't skip one. You take them on, just like you start putting on your clothes, and you start wrap these or clothes around you. And each are a sheath of your body. Hmm? Do what?
Are you
filming? Uh-huh. Yeah. And each are a sheath of the bodies in their own right. So each thing here has the same counterpart. So when you consume an herb, it's hard to realize that it also has its emotional effects on you and it has its mental effects on you. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Oh, God has this thing so... I mean, it's so infused. There's no words. It's just, you know, as you learn more and more how things are interfacing, it's amazing stuff. But these are God worlds. Now, Let me see. I thought I had one here. But I've got this. I was showing you our new God World chart that I had them make. And you can get it from us. But I can't see what I did with it. I got so many papers here. But anyway, it's a picture of the God Worlds. And it's real pretty. I had it made up to show you. It's similar to this, although it's real, it's all color, full color, beautiful stuff. But this shows you the, and we sell it, I think $5 or something, you know. But it shows you all the God Worlds in creation and above. And it just shows you all these different levels. And these have all been mapped out by different religions and different people, different spiritual guides and masters are a little higher than others. And so they bring out more information. And it's been that sort of thing. So depending on the teachings that you've been with, they have different levels that they've acquired. Christianity has levels. Different levels of Christianity have different levels. Hinduism, Buddhism, these are all at different levels within these worlds. And you can go to these places. I mean, there's just so many things there. But your questions, I like these kind of questions, because you have to understand that this world is so much more involved than you think. So much more involved than you think. Look at the crystals and look at the gemstones. These are energetic feeds to this planet. I mean, I told you the book Gifts of the Gemstone Guardians. We listen to what these beings have to say about the gemstones and why they exist. It's just amazing. I believe classical homeopathy can detox these pharmaceutical energetic blocks, but with this method, each drug vaccine is detoxed individually, which can take years, hoping to heal all on all levels. Value your insight. Thanks for the questions. Now, you know, this is where I probably depart from homeopathy, because to give you an example, to neutralize or to detoxify, let's say, quinine, you have to take quinine, its essence thereof. There's no way. Their homeopathy really, to me, isn't a real great detoxifying modality. Naturopathy is. It is the regenerative detoxification modality, not homeopathy. Homeopathy is a treatment-based system, and a good one. I have nothing negative to say about homeopathy. I love it. I've said this over and over and over. Medical doctors need to be homeopathists. Then the death rates will be... Well, there'll be too many people on the planet again, because all these millions of people that die each year from pharmaceuticals, medical doctors, and hospitals won't be dying. Well, but when you're getting into real tissue regeneration, that's not homeopathy. That's us. But we're like the core. Naturopathy is at the core, not naturopathic medicine. That lost the planet. Naturopathy's always been at the core, because you have to roll up your sleeves and fix how you're creating all these problems. And homeopathy doesn't do that. It's a treatment-based modality. You have to roll up your sleeves and actually go on your raw foods and actually use your herbs and detoxify. You can throw homeopathics in with herbs. It doesn't matter, because there's nothing more powerful than the botanicals themselves at these levels. You know, homeopathy is powerful, but it's only the essence thereof, which is just fine, energetically speaking. It's more involved in the energetic side of plants and things, which has its vibration frequencies like everything else. Everything is vibrational. So everything has an effect, good, bad, or indifferent. So I do like homeopathy, like I said, but naturopathy is at the core. From this, that's your GP. If I need a chiropractor, I'm going to recommend a chiropractor. If I need an acupuncturist, I'm going to recommend an acupuncturist. If I need a massage therapist, I would recommend. These are not health modalities in and of themselves. They're therapeutic modalities where you can go and find therapeutic work. But if you want to regenerate, make well, and rebuild, you're at this level, naturopathy. And it's the only level man needs to be right now. And he can use homeopathy to treat, but he needs to work himself up into these higher levels. And this is where this planet has to go, to some degree thereof. Boston Red Sox. I like that. Dear Dr. Morse, thank you for all that you do. I'm a 27-year-old active male who is currently detoxing. Good man. Went a little crazy on the berries today. My question is regarding, I wonder what that is. My question is regarding premature ejaculation. Everything else in this area appears to be healthy. I've heard you speak of the mind being a computer, which is programmed and can be reprogrammed. Absolutely. Oh, you can reprogram yourself all day long. And remember, you can use music to do it. You can use highly discordant music to break your thought patterns up and then replace it with soothing music. You know, even Handel used to play that to break your thoughts up, and then you could use Beethoven or someone to put it back, you know. Or Enya or something neat, you know, like that. Modern day stuff. It's something I have struggled with all of my adult life. I'm unsure it's mental, physical, genetics, adrenals, nerves, or what. Thank you and God bless. Well, you know what? That's a good question, you know, and I think it's more neurological and more in that vein. But I would work on my prostate gland, my kidneys, you know, that sort of thing. A prostate gland, I put some herbs in there. You could also do the male if you don't have any prostatitis, you could use the male reproductive and start strengthening the prostate, the gonadals, you know, and the kidneys and adrenal glands. That's all in the mix. And then you'll get away from that. That's what I would do. That's the only way I've been able to get people away from that sort of problem. But, good job, man. Good job. 27, get yourself healthy. Remember, all that's tied to the kidneys and adrenal glands. So you need those adrenal glands to get the testosterone, but you also need the testes and the prostate. So you make everything healthy. But if you want to make strong, which I would recommend, then go to the male reproductive formula, and that'll start strengthening up that tissue. You could go in a brain and nerve formula, too, to strengthen up that. You know, everything just strengthen up. You might even be too sensitive in an area. You know, there's a thing about being oversensitive and not sensitive enough. So that's the only thing you can do with those type of things is make healthy. Make well that which is, because either one is a problem, you know. Suppression of the nervous system or an overexcitement of the nervous system, either one. Mm-hmm. This is Heather. Hello, Heather. I was fine then last October. I started feeling really bad. Like I was dying. Went to doc a few and all labs came back normal. Not surprised. Because you remember, most labs take and count about 90% of blood work, and about 10% of that blood work you can about ohm up to the length. You know, like your liver enzymes and alkaline phosphatase and your creatinines and things like that. That gives you a look into the lymph system. Even your cancer markers and stuff is kind of a look into the lymph system, PSA, stuff like this. Now, homocysteine, that sort of thing. C-reactive protein, stuff like that. But blood work can look great, and you'd be there having a tumor or having all kinds of problems. Acidosis, the breakdown of the nervous system. Your blood work's going to still look good. See, the blood is only a small part or a small piece of a collage of looking at a client. That is my least piece of evidence that I use in looking at a person's problems. That shows me more immediately where they are in problems or not. The more long-term issue is definitely the iris. You can use CAT scans and things like that as well, but you know, a lot of radiation in these sort of tests to get a minimal outcome of them. But blood work can not just show you too much. And you wonder, well, you're in good shape. And a medical doctor say, this is in your head. I've had plenty of clients tell me that through the years. So listen to all this. I have EBV, okay? And that could be causing my symptoms of chronic sore throat and fatigue. Okay, EBV, Epstein-Barr virus. Not on your life. Epstein-Barr virus, that's one of the easiest viruses to detox out of your body there is. They blame it on chronic fatigue syndrome, but you remember this. Of course, viruses are acids or proteins. And yes, too many viruses can create a problem, but their problem is simply, viruses come in and out like everything else. They detox out easy. But they're proteins. So when your lymph system isn't detoxing or isn't filtering properly, you can hold virals where you all see HIV viral loads, Hep C viral loads, but you detox those right out. Anybody that's got HIV or Hep C viral load, it's easy to get them out of your body. But you can't get them out of your body when you're trying to attack something that you can't kill. It's not like it's a living organism. So that's part of the problem here. But you just need to detoxify yourself. Chronic sore throat. All right? Where would that show up in your blood work? It wouldn't. Because a chronic sore throat isn't about blood whatsoever. It's totally about lymph and mucus. So when you go to detoxify, you could get a real sore throat and pretty soon, a big wad of mucus and your sore throat is gone. So you really need to, you only can detoxify this out. And this is your lymph system, dear one. This isn't your blood system. Brain fog, lymph system, no appetite. Well, again, you could have a lot of inflammation in the gut and you just don't want to eat. Feels like pressure in my temples. Yeah, and it could be too. And that's what you don't want, any of these type of pressures. You got a sore throat though, a chronic sore throat. So that means your lymph system, right, is backed up in your head. Well, you got a couple of eyes up here and some CNS, central nervous system there, the computer, the hard drive to the body. Few things that can get real beat up, like brain fog, honey, where'd I park the car, or is this my house? You know, stuff like that. And that's none of that's good. You know, none of that's good at all. And then it comes the pressures and the comic pressures in the eye and then the MACDs and all the other crap like that. And hard lymph node on right side of neck. All right. You got to fix yourself up, dear one, because now you're getting more into serious problems. A hard lymph node on your neck, not good. You don't want to keep that there. This is where there is absolutely this survival rate in allopathy. There's no survival rate in esophageal type cancers, and that's where you're going. So you got to get this out of there. So you got to get after that GI tract of yours. Start getting on the stomach and bowel, GI broom, start heading down that road at the same time. You're getting the kidneys, you're in the adrenals, right? You're in the lymph system. You got to go after these systems. I had to candle my ears, about 3 per ear, and boy, would I use hot and cold compresses, neural lymphatic points down this spine, because you want to open yourself up. This is bad stuff sitting right at the edge, okay? So, honey, you the more you tell me, all right, here's more. Have psoriasis and got psoriatic autism, BC of it, and the doc says that's nothing. He can do. I started taking your adrenal, kidney, and lymph. Any others I need to take? If it tells me, my doc, I would be going after my GI tract heavily. I'd be going after upper circulation and brain and nerve, given what you're saying here. Go on the first kit. That'll get rid of Epstein-Barr fairly easy out of that. Bit not difficult to clean all that out of the bowels. But I would do the upper circumbrainer nerve. I'd go after my adrenal glands. I don't know about your parathyroid, thyroid, or anything like that, but I would certainly be going just what you're doing. I'd do 2 kidney formulas, 2 lymphatic formulas, 1 capsule, 1 liquid. Go after yourself and don't play around. You've got a serious problem here. Go on a fruit diet and do on a grape fast. Big deal. You're eating. Just thank God you can eat and still take care of this. In the olden days, it was water fasting. So, you know, take after this. And you might, if you don't feel like you can do this, you might get some help here. Because I'll tell you what, you're sitting on the edge of some bad stuff going on in throat and head. You know, when you have chronic sore throat, it doesn't go away and a medical doctor doesn't know what that is. Wow. Wow. Mimi? Hello, Mimi. There's a lot of names for a lot of mom, a lot of grandmothers out there. A lot of babies call their grandmothers Mimi. I think that's what this is, in my mind. Thanks for the recent video on the healing crisis. Thanks. You know, I was thinking there's some things I left out I'd like to talk about, too, and then I forget what I was... forgot. I forget what I remembered and I forgot what I remembered, but I forget. It's like, oh man, But the healing crisis, absolutely. Just realize that, guys, that the healing crisis is not always fun. And that don't freak out that your symptoms are coming back and anything like that, because it does make you feel that. Nope. It's to be welcomed, because a healing crisis is your next journey. It's like an initiation. Boom, you're done with that level. Now you're going to a higher level. So it needs to be exciting in the pain of it all. Now, a lot of healing crises, of course, are not painful. Most of them are just simply cold and flu-like symptoms where mucus is coming out everywhere it can. But there's all levels of healing crisis, and I gave you a lot of different ones to show you that sometimes when you're working with the chronic and the extreme like we do, you're going to have extreme healing crisis. But you don't want to falter. You want to walk straight down the golden road to Wellville. Forget going off the pass. Go straight. And once you get there, it's Oz time. Happy time. Fun time. Healthy times. Awakened times. And we're all here waiting on you. Let me see here. Like when your kidneys aren't filtering and you take too many lymphatic herbs when you have had chronic illness for many years. Well, that means then you want to really hit your kidneys, you know. And, you know, when you come to these sort of things, we use two lymphatic formulas on people because for those of you that are working with others, you see what you're up against. This isn't Toyland. And medical doctors are so far, no offense, but they're so far out of their league. They don't have a clue. This isn't Toyland of people's lives, but you can work with people's lives and bring them back to Wellville each and every time. There's only a few people out there that are so advanced you can't save them. But try they must, because this will set them up for their next experience. This will help to make them grow more for their next experience. So if you have someone you're working with and they pass, don't feel bad. You've done everything you can do, because if this level can't get you, you're going. I've always said, if this level can't get you, go to the medical doctors, because there's no way you're probably going to make it. Because there's not too many people we can't turn around at any level there is. It's just reversing what's causing these things. It's just nothing miracle stuff. There might be some of that shaking in there, some fairy dust and stuff around from some of the little friends we have around. When I detox my eating more raw and mostly fruit, my symptoms of anxiety, insomnia, and brain fog get worse and can stay that way for weeks or months, then I highly recommend you go on Parasite M about a dropper and a half full four times a day for a good month. You need to get the fungus out of you, because that's what you're going at. And of course, when you go on this, and here's some of the issues. When you go on raw, there are absolutely no stimulants. And what it sounds like to me, you're in serious adrenal fatigue. And I would like to see what you are off of meat, off of all protein and everything else. My guess is you bottom out. My guess is you have 80 over or 90 over. Because when you go on fruit, that is where the energy and nutrition is. The thing is, though, it's non-stimulants. It has no neurotransmitters, no proteins per se. They're amino acids, but they're non-stimulants. And this is you're needing something to keep you up. And that's not good, because look at this. As we go on here with this case, she has her symptoms of anxiety, insomnia, okay? Insomnia and brain fog get worse. So you've got a lot going up in here. Insomnia, of course, is the pineal gland, your spiritual gland. And of course, these problems are tied to the transverse bowel. You only know that, and we were only educated to that when a medical doctor discovered iridology. We, through the years, discovered that your colon, of course, embryonically, is tied to everything in your body. Of course it is. And then, of course, that's electrical, and so it all is so tied together. And we've learned that through the years, you know, and how to deal with that sort of thing. So what's happening here is your glands, and we're up in the pineal pituitary area, and this is where you might have some serious problems with the pituitary. You need to get a picture of your eyes. It's easy, and take a look at what you see, or send them in here and have someone help you, because, dear one, you want to take a look at that. Also suggest you're so full of fungus. You know, you want to take care of that. But you want to take a 400 milligram. I'd start off with a 400 milligram adrenal glandular. At the same time, I'll do a pineal granular just to sleep and get my rest. I'm upper circ, brain and nerve. I'm chomping down on the bowels to clean them out. GI tract, stomach and bowel, whatever you need. A GI broom, a lymphatic capsule. I'm honking down on my kidneys. I'm going to move on those. I'm on the herbs. If I need to support my energy levels, then I'm going to do the superfood blend. We have our muscle bodybuilding blend coming soon. So that's you guys, that's not good. I don't like what you're saying here. You can turn this around on yourself totally, but you got to do some of these things. After many months, I don't feel I have broken through any healing crisis. Well, we got to turn around and get yourself focused properly. That's what we have to do. Get yourself focused properly on a proper protocol and going after proper things here. It'll help you out better getting on a proper protocol. Look at the 12-week or the 14-week program and look at that protocol and see that. And that's pretty much what you want to follow. But I would hop on upper circuit and brain and nerve right off. You're going to get blood more, oxygenated blood up in the head. You're going to turn on the neurons. So that's going to help in the hypothalamus, the pituitary, the pineal. That's going to help. You got to go down to the bowels and start cleaning the bowels up. Cut off that feed of the transverse bowel. Same time, you're going into the kidneys and adrenal glands, right? And then I'll do the endocrine glands. So I'm on an adrenal 400 granular to support my adrenals. I'm going to do that for about a month, month and a half. And then I'm going to pop adrenal herbs, hitchhiked with licorice root. I'm going to get away from the glandulars in about a month and a half, and I'm going to pop on adrenal tincture or capsule, piggyback with licorice root. I'm still going to do the endocrine gland because I suspect that your pituitary is involved in this. And so you want to take a look at all that and definitely get things moving, sweetie. Definitely get things moving. You have to break through this. But if you get on the right herbal program, do some green drinks front, get the fungus way down, get everything opened up, then you can go full bore right into the fruit and you'll be good. This is Julie. Where is that? We have so many things here. Holy moly. Oops. A few years ago, I was diagnosed with eustachian tube problems, also called tuba aparta. This means my eustachian tube is open most of the time, which leads to hearing myself talk and breathing constantly. I can hear the tube close and open. Wow, boy, are you sensitive. It's really bad during the winter months. Is there anything I can do about this? A doctor gave me a cortisone nose spray, but that gave me several nosebleeds a day. I'd stop that, Julie. Hell yeah. Okay, so here's the thing. I would definitely candle my ears. I'd candle both ears in about 3 candles per ear. It's gentle. And it'll help. It'll help open that up. Get on your detox, particularly get the bowels. You can take the antispasmodic. I don't know if that'll help you in that case, but that's showing how you're getting a real weak nervous system there. You're really weak with that. And so you're losing connective tissue integrity, probably valvular integrity. So you definitely want to look at that and probably look at the parathyroid gland in this case. At least that would be where I would be going. I'd be going parathyroid, piggybacked with the bones formula. But first, I want to take a look at myself. I'm going to look at my eyes. I want to look at my bowels. I want to look at my kidneys. I want to look at my lymph system. I want to look at my ears and my eyes. See, I can see my ears and my eyes. So I'm going to take a look at all this. I'm going to see where the condition of my brain is in these, the right and left lobes. I'm going to take a look at the cerebellum. I'm going to take a look at this. Because I tell you what you're going to find. You're going to find a lot of inflammation, a lot of lymph. And you might even see some calcifications of the eustachian tubes. So you want to be real careful here. This is all, again, about acidosis. This isn't nothing more than that. And so you want to clean and strengthen, clean and strengthen, clean and strengthen, and that'll go away. Clean and strengthen, clean and strengthen. See what I mean? Because to clean is to remove acids, to get any obstructions, mucus and the like out of the body, and to strengthen is to strengthen up the cells. And as you do that, there's nothing you can't overcome. Nothing. Those are you're right on top of truth. And it's got plenty of petroleum jelly. I can be bad. But that's the way I'd go. Definitely go in those ways. Because it's going to sometime affect your eyes and your brain and your thinking power and maybe even come back to the cerebellum. So you want to real, and the mastoids, of course. So you want to be real careful. and get that lymph moving, get all this inflammation out, all these acids out, and strengthen. And that'll strengthen the connective tissue in the tubes. It'll strengthen all of that. But when you start to see weaknesses, valves and tubes open and stay open, all these sort of things can be neurological, but most of the time you're losing calcium in the, and you've got to worry about calcification of the tubes as well. But this is true with all the ducts and tubes. This is true with all the ducts and tubes, whether it's a bile duct, the pancreatic duct, it doesn't matter. This is true with all of them, the valves of the heart, the tricuspid, the mitral, all of these. It's true with all these things in the body. And you see reports where you have calcification of the tricuspid or mitral valve, things like that. So you have regurgitation with that. So you have, which means blood going backwards. So this is some of the things that you run into when you start to acidify the body, and then the body's response to that to stay alive. And in that, it can kill itself. So, you know, it's just some things you have to look at and take care of here. But good questions today. Really good questions, guys. Love your questions. Really good. We only have a little while left, but I'm going to be in here the rest of the week, except Friday. I'm going to be in here the rest of this week doing sitting with you and talking with you about this, because we got to catch up, and that's just one pile. But many of you are asking questions that many people are suffering with, so I love that. It'll help a lot of people just to answer your questions. So even though these questions are geared for the individuals, they are broad range because there's so many like things. We only have so many tissues in the body. Remember that. We only have so many organs and glands. Easy to learn. The children will learn them faster than the adults. I stumbled across a video from you regarding eye color and seeing the sickness in the body in the eyes. My question is, I was born with very dark brown eyes, but in my early 20s, the area closest to my pupil dramatically lightened. It now is a very light brown or hazel color. I am wondering if you could give me some insight as to why or what caused this. Of course, when I pointed this out to people, no one believes me. Jen, you send me a picture. You send me a picture, honey doll, and put your name on it, Jen K. And that this is the eye you talked about. And let me take a look at that, baby, and I'll tell you. If you have true brown eyes, most true brown eyes are light brown. And when you look at them through the iris, you will see shades of brown. The darker the brown in the iris is more your lymph backing up. The lighter brown is more your true color. You have to take a real good look at that to make sure that is light brown. If indeed that is green, and you have green in your eye, that is a blue eye. There is no green in a brown eye. Impossible. So if you have green in a brown eye, that's a blue eye that is chronic, very chronic in its lymph system. And I've had them. I think I've showed you guys some. And of course, in class we show them, where the brown eye is almost all brown, 90, 95, 98% brown, and only a speck or two of blue. Seen them. Had them. Had a colonel's wife in here, Air Force colonel's wife in here, and I only saw two little spots of blue. And I told her, I said, honey, you got blue eyes. And she looked at me and she said, you're nuts. Well, he's a colonel, you know, and I'm going, oh, man, he probably thinks I'm a square box. So I said to her, I said, honey, I bet you $100 the day you were born they were blue. And she looked at me and she said, you know, my mom said I did have blue eyes the day I was born. But look, they're brown. They're not brown. Her second eye picture, we showed you those at this class, was at least 20%, 25% blue after only 3 months of detox. I mean, it's like, wow. So, you know, you never know until you get into those tissues deeper. Sometimes you guys send me eyes and I just can't tell. And I'll tell you on your eye report, I just can't tell until you detox a little deeper. Because some brown eyes are actually blue eyes with chronic lymph. And it's pretty prevalent today in today's time and the condition of the human condition. But if you see green in there, and that's green, not light brown. Because most brown eyes are light brown. Some blacks have very, very dark eyes and they're going to be dark like that. But as a rule, most brown eyes are light brown. But I've had them that were blue. Funny stuff, you know. But we don't think about those things because, you know, these sciences, some of them are small and nice. And iridology is just an incredible science. Been in the medical hands for the first 50 years. So, wasn't in our hands. But boy, what a science. What a beautiful, simple science. All you young guys and gals, you can learn it. You impress your schoolmates by being able to look in their eye and tell them where their problems are. I mean, this could be a real good world coming. Okay. Yeah. Thanks, Jen. I'll be excited to see that. Waiting for the pick. That's a neat thing because we all can help each other. See, and I love that, don't you? I love the fact that we're working together as one. You know, it's just important that we do that. 11-11, remember that. We're individual, but we are one. And it's just the way creation is. And when you get that, you'll be the next Jalen and Ruby. You'll be out doing whirling dervishes out in the drive, and your love for God is so immense and enormous because you see it in every single thing that exists. It's an incredible experience. Hey, Luke. My friend has brain damage to her frontal, parietal, and temporal lobes, back problem in her lower back, up to her spine and her neck and shoulders. Well, you know what? Since she had that damage and she's not repairing it, you can easily see that because the lower back's in trouble. When the lower back's in trouble, that means your kidney's in trouble. Even if it's from the accident, a lot of times we always have a precursor, a weakness there in an accident. I see this in nursing a lot of times. A nurse will, or a CNA or someone will pick up a patient and turn them wrong and their back goes out. Yeah, they always had back weakness already there before, even though they may not have felt it. But most of the time they feel it a little bit, might not admit it. So, the reason this damage might not be healing, of course, is what system? There's only one system in the body that helps to clean out the damage, and that's the lymph system. The blood comes in and helps to heal it then. But the lymph system must clean the area first. Remember all that? Clean your wounds? Yeah, exactly. So that's what the lymph system's there to do, and it looks like her lymph system isn't working for her. And that would include the adrenals, the steroids, and all that side of the anti-inflammatory issue. So, what you got to do with this case, of course, is go right after. I haven't read on, but we'll stop right here for a minute. You go right after the kidneys and adrenal glands. A must do, right? Then what have I got? I've got upper circuit, brain, and nerve big time, right? Upper circulation and brain and nerve. Easy to understand why those two, right? What else might I think about? Damage to tissue. I might look at skull. I might look at connective tissue. So I want to make sure that parathyroid's working. So sometime in the first month and a half or so, I'm going to put this person on a parathyroid smacked with bones formula. That way it will help rebuild cartilage and all the other stuff that might be damaged as well. Now, she gets pain in her knees, of course, and back to the kidneys again, and back to that lymph system again. So she can't repair trauma. Remember, when you have a traumatic injury, and you're highly acidic, you're not going to come back well from that. But the same person can have the same injury and come back quite well. It all is about the degree of acidosis and how bad your kidneys and adrenals are not functioning for you. All about that. And the next thing, not only her knees, it'll be her hips. Oh, and then the elbows. Now, everywhere you're excessively moving and you can't remove those acids out, you're going to feel first. She has chronic migraines every day. Well, first thing is to get this lymph and everything moving. Go after the GI tract. Then I don't know if she's been to a chiropractor, but you want to make sure her axis and everything is on straight. You know, all those things are a must do. I'd also candle her ears, get all that cleaned out, work on her neural lymphatics, getting her parathyroid and everything. Her back will straighten up if it's twisted with scoliosis or anything. It'll straighten that up. The migraines will come out of there. She says she feels a migraine in her right eye specifically. Well, it don't matter really. I mean, that probably is the weaker side. But by moving this out, by cleaning and enhancing, cleaning and rebuilding, cleaning and strengthening, you're removing acids and metals and all the other crap that's in there, mucus and everything, that's cleaning. Rebuilding tissue falls under the alkaline sky. She says, always has a migraine or a headache. No, we got to get her out of that. That's not fun. That's not good. I was born on migraines myself. We got to get this little one out. She's diagnosed with ADHD, BPD, PTSD, depression, social anxiety, schizoid PD, depersonalization disorder, and anorexia. She takes, oh my God, a Prozac for headaches and anxiety. What to do? All right, the first thing to do is get her on a program. If she's willing to, and she wants to, Luke, you get her on a program. You get her on cleaning her bowels and her kidneys and her adrenals. That'll bring her up neurologically. Upper circuit brain and nerves going to get up in there and really enhance that part of that. Thinking about the parathyroid and the bones about, like I say, about in a month and a half or something like that. I'd be going up there with the endocrine glands. I'd be going after the GI tract. I'd clean out her liver a little bit. You know, just go into that body and follow. Look at that 14-week protocol. See what we do. I always go after the liver gallbladder, which also cleans the pancreas. injuries the first month and a half or so. Those formulas will also pick up the skin. Look at the lady with the psoriasis. You know, the lady earlier with the psoriasis and all the other stuff, that all cleans up together. But it shows you the lymph issues in these cases. It just shows you the lymph issues in these cases. And you can't clean them up until you deal with the lymph system. And everybody knows that by now that listens to us, because medical doctors have tried to treat these conditions for years with no success. And it's like, instead of hurting your people trying to treat things you know you can't cure, won't you just be truthful? Can't cure it, go somewhere else. Plenty of us out here that can. That's what I do, Luke. Because, again, depression is linked there to the parathyroid gland, so you take a look at that. You can help her with depression with the parathyroid. You can anxieties, of course, with the adrenal glands. This whole depersonalization, this whole thing, once you get her nervous system up, you get her central nervous system back in hard drive again, you get the autonomic responding well, everything is doing well, you'll pull her out of this, okay? But right now she might go through some tough healing crisis emotionally. Got a feeling there's some things going on here. So let her just go through that. Warn her that there could be some serious stuff, but you've got to get her off of Prozac and some of this crap like that. That's, can't tell you, bad stuff. But you can support those endocrine glands instead of weakening of them with the Prozac and the other, you can support her. And that's all cool. Obvious raw food diet. Now, with some emotions, you might have to let her have some cheat days. Love your videos. Oh, man, love you too. But your information on the number of cells in the human body is out of date. Where are we now? We're now at 37.2 trillion cells, not 100 trillion, not 76 trillion. So it's down. Interesting. One publication you sometimes cite is the National Geographic. If I cite their article, the number of cells in the human body is approximately 37.2 trillion. Isn't that amazing? Huh. You know, now you got me curious. So we're going to do some investigation on this. To quote a portion of the article, adding up all their numbers, the scientists came up with, drumroll, 37.2 trillion cells. You know, when I went to school, they taught me 78 trillion. And then recently I saw some medical guy saying 100 trillion. That was about 5 years ago. So who the hell knows? But I like National Geographic. They seem to be pretty right on, but I don't know. What do you think? This is not a final number, of course. I don't know. It's funny. Doesn't really matter what a game it is. Hard to tell. You know, there's so, oh my God, but it's a very good start. While it's true that people may vary in size and thus vary in their number of cells, adult humans don't vary by numbers of magnitude except for in their movies. Yeah. The scientists declare with great confidence that the common estimate of a trillion cells in the human body is wrong. But they see their estimate as an opportunity for a collaboration, perhaps through an online database assembled by many experts. Well, that'd be fun. Thanks, Sharon. PhD biochemistry. Yeah. Boy, you know, you take Sharon as a PhD of biochemistry, University of Chicago, this lady could do some good healing with people. Mm-hmm. 37.2 trillion cells. Now we're going to have to, now we're all going to have to do research and see what we got. Okay. So, it'd be like 37, 37, 2, 38, 40, 40, 40, 40, 40, 40, 50, 50, 50, 50, 50, 50, 50, 50, 50, 50, 50, 50, 50, 50, 50, 50, 50, 50, 50, 50, 50, 50, 50, 50, 50, 50, 50, 50, 50, I just think each one of them is a universe within themselves. Interesting. With subatomic, subnano, nano. I mean, amazing stuff, and we just can't even get to, you know, wrap our head around it. We first have to wrap our head around what we are as a species and what we have to eat as a species and how we clean and rebuild ourselves. Then we can dig a little deeper, because then we have the right biochemistry thinking, the right focus. But, oh, love to have a biochemist here. I love all sciences. I tell you, it's so much fun. I'm kind of like one of those little science brains. I just love that. I remember when I first started taking chemistry, everybody goes, the professor said, are you cheating? Because you're making straight A's. And I said, yeah, I like the subject. And he said, kind of laughed at that. But then, getting about the half of the year, I went down to the other side because I was so busy in my band. I had a band at the time, and my chemistry didn't do too good. But I like biology, and anytime you have a time to take botany, take a little botany, because what we're going to need in the future is a lot of herb farmers, because we're going to run out of herbs, guys, so we need farmers. And so botany is a fun course, too. I tell you, it's all just fun to learn how we, the Creator, put this all together and the differences and all that. Just so cool. But remember, don't get lost in that. This is just playground stuff. Never lose yourself in your academics, or hard to sometimes awake and find yourself. Alexander, my dear man, I've had asthma for 6 years. I'm on week 4 of fruits and herbs, making progress. I'm at the point where I can either take one puff of corticosteroid Dulera daily, plus a few minutes on an albuterol nebulizer as needed. Or I can take 6 to 10 albuterol inhalers per day. Ho-ho! I know they both damage me in different ways, but what would you recommend I do? I'm currently doing the one steroid puff so that I don't suppress mucus in my lungs so much. Yeah, I kind of agree with you there. Well, here's the thing. We have an antispasmodic, and I would be taking that antispasmodic, what acts like an inhaler, but it doesn't have the suppressive effects. With an herbal antispasmodic, it keeps the lungs from being tight and spasming so you can breathe. At the same time, it allows you to expectorate mucus. That's the best of both worlds. Because when your nebulizer is not so bad, but albuterol and some of your inhalers, like Aerobid and stuff, dangerous. Dangerous stuff, because you hit it right on the head. It suppresses and locks that mucus in and dehydrates that in interstitial spaces, only to cause a nightmare from hell in the future. Not good stuff at all. So I'd work myself off. The fact that you need a cortisone shot for that also takes you where? Back to your lymph system and your adrenals and your kidneys. Then, of course, what is asthma? Of course, it's the first sign of COPD, and we've talked about that in recent videos even. That it's not like pneumonia. Pneumonia is just mucus, whether you have pneumococcus or not. But asthma is a neurological connection, right? That's a neurological breathing issue. So the adrenals are key to this. The adrenal glands are key to overcoming COPD at any level it is, including asthma. But also cleaning up the stomach and gut, because this is where you have the autonomic brain, and it controls breathing. So your stomach, your GI tract has to come clean. You can have stomach problems and have breathing problems. You know, this is a big nerve ganglion here, of course, and you can break it down just like anything else. So, you know, good questions. Boy, you guys are submitting some dang good questions. I love that. And then I would use these as needed only. Only as needed. It's called PRN, when needed. And that's what I would do. I would only use these if needed, if the antispasmodic didn't work for me. At the same time, I'm on lungs number 2. I'm on 3 lung T. Not to drink too much of that, but I'm on 3 lung T. Why? I want to break up, because there's always mucus involved as well. But I'm also after brain and nerve number 2. Because I know it's a neurological problem, but I need neurotransmitters, so I'm after the adrenal glands. Because if I can't get my adrenal glands up, then I'm not going to get my neurotransmitters up, and I'm going to have breathing problems and anxieties and all the other things that go with low neurotransmitters. Low blood pressure, all that implies. So you want to go after that. That's your nervous system, that's your adrenal glands, but that also is your lymph system. Amazing how these little areas can control so many other areas. But those adrenals, I've said it before, are just amazing pair of glands that can control so many things. So that's what I do. I use an antispasmodic, and you can use it as often as you want. I use the alcohol-based one much quicker, and I use it for seizures and all that. And I would then go forth and start to clean, put myself all on fruits. Now, you're going to have a healing crisis in the lung sometime where you're going to be thinking you had pneumonia. Hang in there. It'll come out and you'll be good. Use antispasmodics. If you ever get to the point you just can't hardly breathe, make yourself throw up. Keep yourself some Lobelia or something like that and take a couple teaspoons. It'll for sure make you throw up. But I used to do that years ago with COPD when I have these cases and I didn't have everything down just the way I felt I needed it. And I have a healing crisis, I'd make them throw up, make sure you compress the diaphragm, compress the lungs and out, and then they can breathe. Crazy stuff out there, but You know, in situations where you need to help someone in life-threatening situations, you do what you do. You can also use your neural lymphatic points, both frontal, down the sternum, and back. You want to use that for breathing, because that also use your, yes, reflexology, use that. All these things can help without having to use the inhalers and the cortisols. So do your best, but you'll pull yourself out of that, my friend. It sounds like you're focused good and everything else, Alexander. You'll be fine. Pull yourself out of that. All right, look at this. Dr. Morse, they are finally starting to catch to you. Thanks for the wonderful info. Prostate cancer survivors face increased risk of dying from other illnesses. No kidding. This ought to be interesting. Researchers from Vanderbilt University has published a new study stating that treating prostate cancer patients with androgen deferential therapy, ADT, raises the chances of developing several other cardiovascular diseases. I just love the word they call diseases. One disease, if we treat that, can cause some other diseases, and bop, 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 bop. I mean, it's like, oh, please. God, guys, break the chain. Break the chain. Come aboard. It's crazy. Yeah, no kidding. ADT reduces serum testosterone within the body, and this in turn minimizes the growth of prostate cancer tumor or shrinks the growth. Now see what they try to do, and of course Lupron is one of them, you know, that suppresses testosterone. But, you know, it's like Rumidex and Tamoxifen for females to suppress estrogen. These are considered cancer-causing drugs by the World Health Organization. So holy crap, here we are, American medical doctors giving cancer-causing substances to treat cancer. That makes sense. If you're crazy, I mean, it's like, oh man, oh, this is all the same type of stuff. But researchers say treating a patient with one particular kind of medication or therapy can affect the health of other dependent organs. No kidding. So if you have prostate problems, where's your problem? Kidneys. If you have ovarian cysts, uterine fibroids, where's your problem? Kidneys and adrenals. Yeah, I mean, we're still looking at the effect when we're looking at the prostate. We're still looking at the effect, because prostatitis and prostate cancers is all different levels of acidosis, isn't it? One extracellular, one intracellular. Inflammation on the outside, deterioration on the inside of the cell. You don't keep acids. You don't hold stool or urine forever, do you? No, you want that out of your body or you're going to get kicked. Same thing, same thing. So I'm glad you're aware of that. Thank you who sent this to me. Appreciate that. The U.S. Centers for Disease Control and Prevention, CDC, said about, I love those guys, dishonest as hell, said about 610,000 patients die from cardiovascular-related problems every year. Isn't that stupid? That's a little over 500,000 people die each year and didn't even have to die. I mean, that's all stupid stuff. Probably from the treatment of course. So they're relating prostate cancer to cardiovascular problems. How is that related? The lymphatic system, absolutely. Because when you're looking at occlusions anywhere, you're looking at the lymph system interstitially. Now, wait a minute. There's only two cells thick. Absolutely. Absolutely. And over half of these are men. No one is simply a prostate or a heart, and the treatments we use to treat one illness or another can radically affect the well-being of other parts of a patient. You know, who is this? Is this a girl? Yeah, took a female to come out with that. It took a smart female, a smart woman to come back and say, look, men, you're sleeping. Yeah, thanks for that. Thanks for that. But just remember, the kidneys are that's your board. That the kidneys and adrenals, that's your core. And everything springs from that, lymphatically speaking. Everything. And of course, your skin's involved with this big system as well. Has to be. Because of the 37.2 trillion cells that we now have, instead of the 100 trillion or the 80 trillion or whatever, they all need some good loving. They need to be able to eat and poop correctly. Thanks for that. I love this. It's good stuff. We're going to put that up on our website. But this is what we're seeing. You guys are going to know a lot of this so early on. It's not even funny. But thank God some people are coming to this. They're finding the lymph systems now a little more, and they're thinking about the lymph systems a little more. We're going to give them a lot more to think about, aren't we? It just takes a while for them to catch up. It always has. But they'll catch up, maybe. But this is a serious blow to their profession. But you know what? Sometimes we have to stand up and go, you know what? We all had it wrong. We're learning now, and it's time for us to grow in a different area. There's nothing wrong with saying that. I am never so ego that I can't say, oh, no, I learned that, you know. I thought differently at the time because I went through my different things, you know, thinking one thing and then being aware, oh, wow, but look over here. You know, we're always at that. There's always could be a little more aware. There's always someone stronger or more aware. Of course, there's always the ones the other way, too. So you can never deny yourself for anything. Life is just the way it is, and there's no need to judge anybody for anything. It just is. Just is. Kelly, I've never seen it spelled that way. K-E-L-L-I. Kelly Rush. Upon awakening this morning, I was telling my 40-year-old, oh, that's cute, that he is so smart due to eating all the fruits he does that he can be anything he wants to be when he grows up, but it would be great if he could do something where he's helping people and be directly helping people. And he directly said, I can be just like Dr. Morse. Oh, you're gonna make me cry. Oh, give me him a big hug. I'll give him a big hug from the camera. There, your little 4-year-old love, and I love you, son. Thank you so much. Was this a daughter or a boy? My question is, son, he has lost most of his two front teeth due to sucking at night. He never used a pacifier or bottle at night. Could it be low adrenals, nervous system? Yeah, it could be. Yeah, it could be, definitely. Of course, you don't know what's going on here in teething, but at the same time, let's see, he's 4 years old. You got him on fruits, berries, and melons. Make sure his parathyroid. He's 4 years old. Maybe you slip a picture of his eyes and take a look at him. That'd be cool. I mean, there's these little Irish cameras for kids, but if we could get a picture of his eyes, boy, that would show you everything there. You might have a little fungus in him and stuff like that. You might get a little parasite in him along with some fruit juice, a couple drops, just to see if you can get some fungus out of him and stuff like that. Make sure you ain't got any worms or anything like that going on. You know, detoxify that side of it. Of course, at 4 years old, you know there's kidneys and adrenals involved, so I would probably do a couple drops of kidneys, a couple drops of adrenals, maybe an endocrine gland. It'll pick up all the other endos, and as this baby grows on the fruits and the berries, it's going to grow strong and big, don't forget, and you can help him grow out of any of these weaknesses that he's got. But I'll give him a big hug. Thank you so much. That's sweet. I tell you, these young lads and gals, these are the future of the planet. You know, and we need to make them healthy and awake. And boy, what a change that'll make. You know, we're steeped in the center of this corruption and the heaviness that this planet has gotten itself into. So we're just infusing this with light and love and beauty and truth. Essential. But then the young ones will come and really change it. And that's what I'm excited about, you know. Oh, hey, dude. What do we got going here? Dr. Morris, Sonny. Hey, Sonny, dig the picture. Love the beard, man. Sonny here, Miss Arizona. Hands down, you are a gift from our... Oh, thanks, my friend. That mugshot was taken on December 21st. Just 2 months ago, when I turned 67 years young. I like your way of thinking already. You know, when someone says old, I'm always thinking young. Even though I read it, I say, you know, I'm thinking young. You know. My secret to staying young is staying in the presence of our Heavenly Father. There is no time in heaven. Therefore, a person doesn't age. Age, right? You know, I do, you know. Absolutely. You know, the more that you become yourself, who you really are, the God force, that's who you are. And it just helps to heal and energize you. I know there's a lot of obstructions on the way down to get the bodies and everything else, but you know, we're working on the way back. I take no meds. I am on my third 14-week protocol, but you know, sometimes that's what it takes to knock the body back to health again. I did my first one 2 years ago, my friend. Dr. Marcy has been a great soul blessing for me. So oil pulling for the teeth, good or bad, and why? To see, brother. Oh, by His grace, Sonny. P.S. I coined this saying many years ago. Freely I receive it, freely I pass it on to you. Excellent, my friend. The truth may hurt, but the lies will kill you. You got it. The truth might hurt, but you know what? You can't let the truth hurt. The truth is what it is, and embracing that, you pull yourself to righteousness. You pull yourself to being the beautiful one that you are, but the individual one that you are, because there is endless amounts of activities to be involved in, interplanetarily speaking. What a long, strange trip it's been, bless you all. Hasn't it, my friend? An interesting one, huh? Especially if they sent you through the plant life. So, oil pulling for the teeth, good or bad? You know, I think oil's a good anti-inflammatory, but if you want to pull the crap out of your gums, get the heal-all tea and start holding that in your mouth. It's anti-inflammatory, has a little plantain to pull. I've used that for all types of problems in the mouth. Oil pulling, there's not a lot of astringent value to oils, in my opinion, to be honest with you. More anti-inflammatory. You want astringents, use lemons in the mouth. You want astringents in mucosa, and you want to move the acids instead of having them go through the lymph system as much, you have to astringe. And oils are not astringent as well. So I would use the heal-all tea. It's what I designed it for. I use it for abscesses, cracked teeth, and everything else, and start to pull and get the teeth back in shape. You know, make sure your mouth is always alkaline. And if you're not alkaline, even off of all foods, and you're acidic, you know that's your lymph system. Totally lymph, but love you, my friend. Thank you much. Thank you much. Yeah, the trip is interesting all the way. This is just a little piece of that trip, you know. Oh, let me see what we got. Magnus, thank you so much for all your videos and guidance. Thank you. Thank you so much. I consider us as doing this together, you know. And thank you for being so supporting and loving in your way of community. Oh, thanks. Thanks. You know, sometimes I get a little strong sometimes on some of you, but I want you to win. I want you to make it, you know. And I just, as they help me here, sometimes I'll get a little strong, and it's just because that's what you need, you know. But it's with all with great love, my guys. Do you know Martin Brofman? I don't. I've been asked that before. And his book, Anything Can Be Healed. No, I'm not familiar with that one. Martin Brofman basically healed himself from a tumor in his spine by changing a number of things in his life, focusing on doing things he really loved to do. This included eating pizza, burgers, etc. What is your take on this? Yeah, all the way from Denmark, baby. I have no take on that. I mean, it depends. You have so many variables, if indeed that's factual. Because, you know, there's some things people claim. But indeed, if that's factual, then a lot of times just the relaxing and getting out of the stress relaxes the adrenal and kidneys. If he's of a strong constitution, then that could have alone helped a little bit. And changing the diet just a tad bit could have helped him to reduce this. As a rule, not much. Because I tell you, you know, tumors are, that's your lymph system. And they can come out easy as you form them if you reverse why they're formed. In other words, as you lose the ability to filter in your kidneys and sweat, you'll form them. As you increase the ability to sweat and filter, you'll lose them. So it's hard to say, you know, what his genes are. But someone that does something like this, if that's factual, only did it because he had strong genes and not a lymph system that chronic. Because by the time you're chronic in the lymph system, you're not going to move a tumor out by the will of God and you're opening up and all that sort of thing. I'm privy to a lot of people that tried that. But there are just certain things you got to do, you know, to each body. Remember, each of your bodies are stuck on different levels, and each level has its own set of rules and guidelines, both in chemistry and physics. And that's the creator. You know? So I profess to know all that. But I do know that. So I don't know how much I dig into that. But for him to suggest in writing a book that you can get rid of your tumors and your cancers and stuff by just being happy and changing some things in your life, I wouldn't, because some of you don't have time to watch that fail. You seriously want to get into what's causing this and backing it up. Just saying, I've been around a long time in this field, and I've seen a lot of people like that, and a lot of people that made claims like that that died because they claims were quite on top. But you know, if he did, good. That means that he could go on this program and shoot the moon, because if you could remove a tumor at what he did, at his body, then he doesn't have a lot of work to do on himself. But most people are a lot more involved in lymphatic than that. It's impossible. So you can try that, but just keep in mind, it'd be good if you did all the other stuff with it. Then, Dr. Morris, I have a question about hair and detox. You mentioned, of course, when you detox and remove the acids from your head area, as well as maybe fix up your thyroid, the hair comes back. But what about for a female with just weak, dry, and split ends? Same thing. You know, dehydration. You know, this is dehydration. And where do you get dehydration? Acidosis. Yeah, I know. Same with split ends, you know, and dry hair and all these sort of things like that. I mean, I've seen so many women turn their hair into soft, lush hair. I've just seen so many of that. There's so many women now that are balding. And of course, men all over the place. All fixable, fixable, fixable. You know, your upper circulation, getting your lymph moving in the head, all that fixes it. Matter of fact, many of you have written me that you got your hair back. People come in here all the time talking to us, showing us their hair and stuff. It's not something that I, you know, have a problem with. Does the hair strengthen and come alive again from the roots to the end, since they are cells? Well, it could be gone all the way down. You know, your body rebuilds cells too, hair follicles and everything. I mean, even if they're damaged, they can be rebuilt. The cool thing about cells is they're regenerable. I mean, you can regenerate the human cell condition, and it's too cool stuff. Or cells multiply, of course, and make their own new cells. I mean, it's just cool stuff. I had a good amount of hair until I was about 15. Oh, Lord have mercy. See, at 15, that's young to start having hair problems. It started to thin, and then when I checked out, they said it was due to low iron, etc. They can blame that, but it's a lymph system. So you get your lymph system moving. Of course, she's 23 now. That tells you're right into kidney and adrenal weaknesses, sweetheart. You're right at the perfect age to have big-time kidney and adrenal problems. So be wanting to look at that at your age, fix this up so you can have children. Everything's good. Children are good. Get a picture of those eyes and take a look at yourself, sweetheart, because you want to make sure, you know, you're right at that age of having babies and everything else. Make sure you're healthy, you know, because what happens to you happens to your offspring, and your lymph system is your offspring's lymph system. You can't genetically pass fluids. I'm 23 now, and of course, it only has gotten thinner. Yeah, you want to stop this pretty quickly. There was one girl that came to class years ago, just hardly any hair at all. She's got thick head of hair. She was a YouTuber. I've also noticed that the roots of my hair is thicker than the ends. How interesting that is. Do you think this is just from everyday styling that a woman does to her hair, or is this acids? Good question. You know, all the stuff women put on their hair and that effect upon tissues and stuff, I don't know. Yeah, there's just so much to all of this, it's hard to say. Because chemistry, of course, impacts on top of chemistry, and it's like, oh, and so much of this is acid chemistry. I would be so bold to say there should never be acidic hair products. Let's be that bold and say that. Perms and stuff are so acidic, of course, that we were talking about that. I was talking about that with some beauticians the other day, that brain cancer and MS is just tops in beauticians that work with perms and stuff. Bad stuff. Bad, 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 bad stuff. Also notice that the top part of my head where the hair grows does not grow, or at least it does. It is extremely slow. See, that's what I'm saying. These patches, that's where your lymph is the most stagnant in the tissues. So, and that's where it's not allowing anything to grow. It's closed off that area, and it's suffocating that area with inflammation and acids, and then it'll be the cells. So this is just typical how the lymph is, and especially in genetic weaknesses. You can see those in the iridology class. Remember, we were showing you guys the lymphatic wall, if you will, of the genetic weaker tissues. When I get this book written on it, I'll have more of that in there. Iridologists know much about it here on this planet, but we'll bring that out. It does extremely slow where it is the mid-shaft grows normal. Is that maybe because of the different toxic lymph levels in my head? It's possible. And that you have low growth factors, absolutely possible. But by the time you get up in the pituitary, you get into the growth factors, and you start cleaning all that up, because you're up in the pituitary hypothalamus area, you're into all the growth factor areas, you're into all those things. That can put an impact on hair growth as well. So you're basically getting to all these tissues and hormones and steroids and all this stuff throughout the body and making everything well and healthy again. Therefore, everything starts growing appropriately, catching up with growth appropriately. Those things that are small gets normal again. Those things big, they might stay big. I don't know. Oh, but interesting stuff. When a woman detoxifies fully, should she expect thick hair always? I don't know how thick. I'm going to say normal hair. I'm going to say thick hair is also aberrated. I had real, real thick hair, but I had a lot of sinus and mucus from all the milk drinking. But I think that too thick and too thin are both sides of the wrong coin, that the middle path is always the way. Remember Buddha, the middle path. The middle way where you have nice hair, not too thick and not too thin. I think that's where you're going. I've never seen anybody at these higher levels of detox complain about too thick of hair. Just normal, nice, nice hair. When a woman detox, okay, or is thick hair an indication of maybe a hyperactive? See, I think thick hair is an indication. Not so much of hyperthyroid. They blame the thyroid on hair. I just disagree. I think we're going back to what that one lady said, why she said the prostate and how you have other problems related to that. See, when time you have thyroid problems, that's the lymph system. And I don't know of any growth factors in the thyroid that affect hair. I only rate a metabolism. So I don't see how that affects hair. You'd be more near itself up into the pituitary area and the like than just the natural blood and lymph flow to the hair follicles itself. When you're going to have a thyroid down, you have a lymph down. And so when you have a thyroid down, you can have hair down. The same system's down that causes both things down. But to blame the thyroid for losing hair, I don't see in the anatomy and physiology of the thyroid where that takes place. If you find that, let me know. Because calcium utilization would be of the parathyroid, and you could, excuse me, you could link maybe a parathyroid weakness where you have low calcium to maybe stunted hair growth. That maybe. See where I'm getting at? So I would definitely want to think that, because you're right in the whole mix of parathyroid, thyroid, you're all in the mix here. Everything's involved. By the time you're lymphatically involved here, all 37.2 trillion cells are involved. No, I think I read the same thing. I get National Geographic at home. I think I read the same thing you did of the 32,000 cells, but I'm not so sure National Geographic has that correct. But I do appreciate National Geographic. There's no question about it. But I think not everything everybody has is correct. You know, some of our stuff might be off some places, and when we find out where, we'll correct all that. But we've got a good way home, don't we? Yep. Not everything's perfect, but we will, and you guys will learn more and find out more, and you guys will write better books, and things will grow, and that's how it's supposed to. Yep. Ashley. All right. Ashley. I think I may have a gluten sensitivity and or candida. Not sure. I have keratosis pathoris. I never could pronounce that quite right. On my upper arms and legs. I have one patch of ringworm on my arm a year ago. Did you really? So it just saying you're full of fungus, you know. I've had bacterial vaginitis maybe twice. Yeah, that'd be bacterial though. Let's talk about that. Constipation sometimes, flatulent frequently. I have frequently sweet cravings. What's wrong with me? Thanks, Dr. Morse. Not much, honey. Think about this. Well, not much that I see here. But okay, so let's look at this. I'd highly recommend that you get the Heal All tea. And you could drink it, but I want you to douche with it. Make it into a pretty strong tea, let's say 4 teaspoons. I say 1 teaspoon for 3 cups of water. And make yourself some skin, you know, boil it up, and then let it cool down to skin temperature. Get yourself a douche bag and go douche with it. 1 time at night for 2 weeks or more. Clean that vaginal wall. I made that tea for these problems, but specifically for atypical cells, because that's where, if you're not careful, you're going to start going. Bacterial, okay, it's just that the fact that you are oozing proteins that the bacteria is trying to break down for you. That's not the problem. The problem is your lymph system vaginally, probably, and be careful about ovarian cysts, uterine fibroids, endometriosis, things like this with this whole thing going on as well. All right, because this is going to take you back to your kidneys and adrenal glands and your lymph system. Remember that? Now, what else did you ask? Okay, yeah, most of these patches are fungal patches, so I would be on the, particularly would be on the Parasite M, probably a dropper and a half for 3-4 times a day for a good month or two. I'm going to make a good kill, but what system would I find the fungus in mostly? Yeah, the sewer system, and I'm going to go after that system. I've had people with toenail fungus, fingernail fungus so bad, you know, they're all yellow and everything, and at the same time, I try to get rid of it all with Parasite M. And until you move the lymph system, are you ever 100% sure? Now, with that, if you have moles or warts, they should fall off too. And you want to take that. If you have moles growing on your warts, you have sugar metabolism problems. This is your adrenal glands. You want to take Parasite M and get these babies off of you. They're just sucking on you. And it's just that you're not metabolizing your sugars. It's the same reason fungus is in you. And of course, fermentation is that problem. Now, you're getting flatulence. Frequent flatulence can be sulfur built up in the interstitially in the gut wall. Remember that? So look at your eyes, see if you have an orange in the bowels. That's sulfur. Or you could have a pancreatic weakness where you have low digestive enzymatic action. Therefore, fermentation or putrefaction is causing that. Or you're combining your foods wrong. You're putting protein and starches together and or fruits on top of other foods. And you're going to always get flatulence with that because all that creates fermentation and putrefaction. So you want to take a look at all that. See if you have sulfur in your gut. If you do, you want to go after your gut anyway. You want to make sure you're digesting your foods properly. You want off all proteins anyway. So take care of those things. Constipation sometimes, yeah, you want to clean yourself up. Get all that cleaned up. Get your adrenal glands up so you get more neural power to the GI tract and to start making things. The sweet cravings is all fungus. That'll all go away. Nothing's wrong with you. You just got to fix a few of these things. But remember the eye picks because that way you can see your inner world of wellness. And that is a worth $1 million because there's nothing like it. And then you can see your own lymph system. This is Jeanette. Had constipation. Wow, things kind of run in the same circles, don't they? Had constipation all my life and started having diarrhea. That never stopped and found infection in colon. So they did colonoscopy and diagnosed is diverticulitis in colon and tortuously on the sigmoid colon. That's a lot of resections in the sigmoid bowel. And can't find out why I'm in so much pain and continued diarrhea if I go to bathroom and not go at all for up to 3 days or more, now that infection's supposed to be gone. Need help because they want me on lenses. I have tinnitus and headaches also. Jeanette, honey, you want to start detoxifying your body, your whole body. Don't just try to focus on one thing. Because if you guys just focus on one thing, your success is minimal. You want to focus systemically, or at least on systems, because your body's divided up into systems. And so you either want to focus on a whole system, like a lymph system, or the digestive system, or the nervous system, or whatever. But your focus needs to be systems. But for me, it's systemic body work. You want to focus on it all together and you'll be totally successful and a happy camper in a fraction of the time. Like someone said here, you go after one little thing and one little thing and one little thing, it's going to take you forever and your success is way low. So, if you have diverticulitis, what is that? That's by bowel pockets, right? That's inflammation of the bowel pockets. Why do you have bowel pockets? Take a look at your parathyroid gland and I think you might do a little work on the parathyroid gland coupled with some bones formula. At the same time, you want to get in and clean your bowels out. So you want on stomach and bowel. I do have to say that if you're constipated like that, I would start out with stomach and bowel number 2. Now number 2 will give you a little nudge. And if you've been through some bouts of diarrhea, okay, but I would do number 2 TID, that's 3 times a day. That's what I would be doing. Seeing how that's going to fix me up. the same time, I'm going on my other herbs. I'm going on my kidneys. I'm going on my adrenals. I'm going after this because if you have stagnation of lymph in the gut wall, it makes the gut wall harder, suppresses neurological function and other peristalsis. That also means that you would have to have a kidney and adrenal weakness, and the adrenal glands produce neurotransmitters that turns on that nervous system. So you're back to the kidneys and adrenals again. I could take you back to kidneys, adrenals almost every time, and especially the sweetheart adrenals with different areas of the nervous system or whatever, different steroids and things like that. Not all the adrenals are fixated on the lymph system. You got all your minerals are utilized there except calcium. You've got your sugar metabolism. You've got a lot of things going on there. Then you got your neurotransmitters and the autonomic. So you got a lot going on in those adrenal glands, not just kidney work and not just lymph work. But it's interesting that it hooked it to them because you have to work on them both to be successful. And you have to work on them because the adrenals go, the kidneys go, the lymph goes. And then everything starts going. So to fix this, to get the inflammation out, you've got to get the lymph out, the stagnation of the lymph out. That weakened your bowel wall, sucked the calcium out, and made a pocket because probably you have a little parathyroid with that. So you want to clean up the gut. You know how we do. We use GI tract formulas. We use the GI broom. I would do that. Start cleaning. Open up the kidneys. Get my bowels working because you don't know what's going on there. You might want to get your eye picture instead of colonoscopy. I could stick a camera up a garden hose and see nothing, except maybe some hanging polyps. But if I have a 360-degree camera that sees all of it, and that's your eye pick, 360-degree view, and that's what you want to look at. How chronic is my bowels? They can't tell you any of those things. The eye can. That's the beauty of it. You can see right where your seriousnesses are, although you can only fix everything as one. How interesting, huh? So go forth, my dear one, and fix these things because you won't be out of pain until you remove the acids. And you can't remove the acids until you get your kidneys and adrenals fixed. Fixing those then will increase peristalsis, blah, 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 blah. And of course, all of that directly is linked to tendonitis and headaches and pressures. See how it's all linked together? One more. This is Terry. Hey, Terry. Hello, Dr. Morse. It's me, Terry. I went to a bioidentical hormone doctor back in 2014 who told me I had an elevated homocysteine, level 10, and wanted me to get down. Get it down, baby. Get it down to level 6 to 7. Yeah, I had fun Friday night. I have a dear friend. A lot of you probably know him, but we had a lot of fun. And I tell you, this guy, I would say his age, but I think it's on his website, but he's in his 50s. But he can belt that out. He did over 2 hours, and I mean belting. That's Brian Adams, baby. And he belted that baby out like crazy, baby. Clearwater. He's in Tampa Saturday night. And so we had fun. He's a good guy. If any of you know Brian Adams, he's such a love. He's such a great guy. And his mom is 88 years old. I mean, it's just incredible. We had a great time. But man, he's been on Raw. He went through our programs a few years ago and never looked back. He's a raw eater. He looks good. His voice is tearing it up. My God. Cool stuff. Anyway, by taking some capsules that they supply. I stopped going there after learning about you. However, can you explain homocysteine to me and what needs to be done to prevent any illness from it? Well, big hugs and kisses to you, baby. You know what? No, this is all about inflammation. And of course, that's your inflammatory markers in some way, and so is C-reactive proteins, but in reality, it's just acidosis. To keep it simple, it's just showing you how acidic you are. And so it is saying you're very acidic. So you want to back up on that and fix that. So go after your adrenals again. Go after your kidneys. Go after your lymph system. Clean up the GI tract. If you want to build your nervous system, do that. Clean out your lungs, do that. You know, and have fun with this, Terry. Yeah. It's just showing that you're full of inflammation. You need to get it out. And that's the lymph system. And you're rocking and rolling, baby. So let me say that I'll be back because your questions are excellent. Excellent. I love that. But we'll have hours to spend together coming in, and maybe Chris can get this up in the morning sometime, but he's got to, well, I'll get Drew to start time stamping this and get this to you. And I have all week to work with you, so thanks for hanging in there on us. I love you guys. It's been a hell week. Last week was so busy, I couldn't even see straight. But it was fun. The class was fun. The iridology class was fun. I had fun with you guys. We were a good class, and we were able to cover all our subject matter, but we still could have used more protocol time. One of the things we do there is I put up an eye picture, and I give you a questionnaire that is filled out, and now you've got to tell me what you're going to do with that person, and all you have the eyes in the questionnaire. Fun stuff. Love you guys. See you next video.